Oh yeah, what's a more exciting way to start an episode than with an elevator ride? Okay, we've got a room full of dudes.
Your tenacity, Adam Jensen, is really quite irritating. We'd like you to stop now.
I'm afraid I can't, Zao. You see, I figured it out. I know what you and your conspiracy buddies are planning.
Do you? How clever.
A new biochip. A software upgrade that limits what augmentations can do. You're creating a kill switch. You kidnap Megan Reed's team to do it, and you're seizing control of the market to ensure it gets distributed. All because you're afraid of people like me. Augmented people, with the power to resist you.
No one's afraid of you, Mr. Jensen. All your blundering around and childish interference hasn't stopped a thing. Tell me, have you been to a limb clinic lately?
No, we haven't. Suck it, Zao.
Let me guess. That was supposed to shut me down, right? Leave me broken and begging?
The orgs were recalled! You should be offline!
Women never fail to underestimate men.
You should have stayed dead, Jensen.
Oh dear. It's Namir. Right, come on. You around? I hope you're still around. Oh no, you're running around in there. Motherfucker. Oh god, I needed energy to use the typhoon again. What a blunder. Right, let's charge him, get the typhoon off. Yeah, have some of that, your mother. Don't like it up you, do you? I mean, yeah, I'm also taking some damage there, but... Hey-ho, is he going to jump over the wall? Not from there, yet. What? What got me? Did he toss a grenade or something? Right, I like opening Typhoon as a strategy, although...
Like a blind man.
F2 is a pain in the ass to hit when you're in the middle of an action thing. Ah, he's throwing gas around as well, so I do need to keep moving. You coming over the wall? Like to see you try. Now where you at? You gonna shoot me so I can see where you are? There you are. Probably within typhoon range. There you are.
Woo!
First try, Pogs.
Finish it.
Not until you tell me where Megan is.
You've lost her, Jensen. Men like us, we never get back the things we love.
Sounds good. Doesn't mean much. Decent last words, though. Talk on quiet. And now I can roam around and loot all these boxes that I could have looted in the boss fight.
3 hours later.
It's time to press on and maybe finally find Megan.
Jaren, is that you?
Not exactly.
Jaren, is that you?
Adam?
Bitch.
Oh my god, Adam! It's you. You're hurt. What happened?
What happened to you? I risked my life for you, Megan. I came halfway around the world, and for what?
It's not what you think.
Are you part of this?
No! No, Adam, I swear it! The kidnapping was real. The attack on Seraph Industries, they came after me. They wanted my research.
And when did you decide they could have it?
It didn't happen like that. I wanted to tell you, but I couldn't. I couldn't! And then David said we had to use it. We owed it to mankind.
David? What are you talking about?
My great discovery. The genetic framework I found that makes it easier for living tissue to bond with implants. I found it. In you, Adam. I used your DNA.
Gasp.
I wanted to tell you, I swear. But David convinced me what it could mean for mankind. How much better off we could all be. It took Hugh to make me see how wrong I was.
Hugh? Hugh Darrow.
Why is everyone involved in this?
After Namir brought us here.
Richard! Patch me into Seraph, now!
Adam, please! He was only pretending to work with Tai Young and the others. He found out what they were planning to do and told them he would help. But only to make sure they never succeeded. Their control signal won't work.
Thank you, David.
She's awfully naive.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Seraph here has asked me to show the world how human enhancement technology can change it. After careful deliberation, I've decided I must do exactly that.
Oh shit, son.
Forgive me.
Oh god. He's modified the control signal. Anyone with a new biochip will be affected. Hugh never said anything about this.
I'm going back for the scientists.
Why would he?
No, Adam! I know the complex better than you. I'll find them. There's a hangar bay through there. Get to its control room and retract the roof. Clear a path for us.
What a bitch. And also, what a naive woman. Oh yeah, Hugh's just doing it for the good of mankind. It's fine. No, that's Hugh's own computer. Yeah, that kind of adds up with everything else. It's all very white. It's all very creepy. Alright then, we've got a room, we've got a hangar, we've got a bunch of dudes down there. Run, scientists, run! She's done it, you know.
I'm getting my team out of here. You have to go to Panchaea and stop Hugh.
You and I aren't done with this, Megan.
I know how it looks, but you have to stop the broadcast. I think it's causing the new biochips to overstimulate the vagus nerve, creating terrifying hallucinations.
You mean it's driving augmented people insane?
Yes, and it's up to you to stop it. Use the Leo shuttle. It will take you to Panchaea. Good luck, Adam.
Lovely shit. So, on to Panchaea, I guess, from the sound of things. But first, let's have a little peek in this PC that's hidden away behind here. Talking about Hangar 18, let's see. Foreign life form inventories. Suspended states of cryogenics. Selective amnesia. Curious stuff, they know too much. He knows too much. Dave 1 to Dave 2. If you know, you know. And you're cool.
I know. I heard it.
If you don't know, then fair enough. It's a Megadeth reference. Song Hangar 18. It's a bunch of the lyrics from it. There were two Daves in the band, so that's Dave 1 and Dave 2. It's cool.
Stand still.
Been spotted.
Automated systems online. Barrow sequence 1, code 1, 1A, preset and ready to engage. Suborbital trajectory plotted. Destination, Panchaea. begin countdown, Mr. Darrow?
Yes, let's begin the countdown.
Begin countdown.
Code 000. Confirm 0. Countdown commencing.
Not today, my friend. Are we stray off Spanchair at this point? Felt sure we had another boss fight against Zhao. Maybe that's in Panchaya.
Stand by for the electrodynamic launch assist sequence
Yeah, it seems like this should certainly be
Jensen.
Another boss.
Jensen, can you read me?
Barely. I've reached Panchaya, Pritchard. Any word from Sarah for the UN delegates?
Nothing. The installation went into lockdown shortly after Darrow gave his speech. I can't tell if anyone's even alive. And the signal's still broadcasting.
Meaning no one's safe till I get in there and shut it down.
You'll have to disengage the lockdown first. Look for a master control panel at the top of the tower.
Master control panel, you say? We can do that. Just sidling round here. No one around though, so it's all good. Probably have a look through those doors, just see what's going on. Is there any reason to? No, it all looks pretty quiet in there. Alright then. Was there anything else worth spending praxis points on? Let's see. Oh yeah, we still need a 0.3 of sprint. I suppose it kind of hurts to get recoil reduction. And now we're in a maintenance tunnel of sorts. Still no sign of bats. We've got a box. But we did pick up EMP shielding again. I mean, we've got everything at this point. So we can just go left again. Oh, yeah, there's EMP mines in here as well. Clever. Now, can we get in there? Is that a breakable window? Nope, pretty sure that would have broken it if it was. Any breaker boxes around here? There's normally one when there's electricity around. Nope, doesn't seem to be anything of interest at all, so we'll just stroll on. Oh, that was an explosive mine. That was mildly interesting, and it has exposed a vent. More explosives, all well and good. And then does this lead round into that room we saw? No. But it does lead to inside. Sweet. So let's press on. Right, now we've got enemies by the look of it. We've got a robot on the radar at least. Oh, it's dormant. Good. For now. The elevators never stop, but this one,
Pritchard,
got boxes.
Here's broadcast centers at the base of the station near the bottom of the ocean. Is that right?
But the lockdown caused all the blast doors to seal. You won't be able to go down until you override them manually.
Of course.
From up in the tower. I got it.
So once again, we've got to get up to get down. Yep, didn't work out well for her. All for them. It's all getting a bit spookums. Definitely take the painkillers. Now, what have we got? Is that someone shambling around outside? Yeah, it's weird. We've got like org zombies, basically. And they shamble about. They're a bit unpredictable in their movements, and they're pretty tough. But you can just knock them off pretty easily as well with a silent takedown. So, let's see. We've got one just hiding there somewhere. Is it worth trying to lure him in by throwing something in his way? What if we take this out here? Pop it down, and at least we could hide behind it. Plus we've got this little room for any good reason at all. For the vent, that's why. And hopefully all of this will lead to me sneaking up on this guy. He doesn't seem to be turning around all that much.
I don't want it like that. It's okay, I hear it. Look, we're gonna go around. We're gonna go around the other side.
Yeah, he's mad. Sleep it off. Maybe we'll have a cure for you at some point. Hopefully. I don't know exactly what it's doing on a biological front to these people, but I assume it'll just be thingamajig, reversible afterwards. Not for her, obviously. Such is life. Right, so is there anything worthwhile in here? Plasma capsules? I didn't take the plasma gun off Namir's bod, because didn't want it. Although, am I going to be able to use the silent sniper rifle again? Or has it had its brief day in the sun? It's probably done, to be honest. We'll hang on to it. It's like a lucky charm. Ooh. So yeah, we're down the Arctic Sea, I think. Down south. It's very cold. Out there, at least. It's nice in here. All the heating's still working. It's almost worse that there's no body there. Oh, look at this. Great. They didn't want us getting through that one, did they? No. Fine. More storerooms? What am I even doing at this point? I should just be advancing to the objective. I've got all the loot I need. Get me through everything. Let's see. Nothing useful. A turret that still works. It's a bit slow though. And that's a dead end, but turret's coming back. Oh. Aha.
I don't think you want to do that, Mr. Jensen. Disengage lockdown, and whatever demons this station contains are likely to come crashing out on us.
Afraid to die, Darrow? Or just unwilling to face what you've done?
Oh, I know what I've done, believe me. I take no pleasure in it.
And yet you still did it.
I did what had to be done. 20 years ago, I gave the world augmentation technology. I thought I was giving it a bright future, but instead I gave it the means to destroy itself. No law, no UN regulation was going to fix that.
People are dying out there.
hundreds of thousands of people driven to the brink of insanity because of you.
I had to convince the world. Before today, people believed we should steal fire from the gods and redesign human nature. Human nature is the only thing we have that gives us a moral compass and the social skills we need to live in peace. Destroy it, and you destroy our very species.
Don't paint yourself a savior in this. What you're doing is insane.
Is it? When this is done, the Illuminati won't be able to control men and women like you as they had planned from the inside out. No one will be able to use the technology I invented to make others into beings they desire. Something we both know has happened already.
You think you're Frankenstein, killing his own monster?
Actually, Mr. Jensen, I prefer to think of myself as Daedalus, watching helplessly as his child crashes into the sea.
I'm ending this. Now.
You can't. The signal is being generated from the broadcast center at the base of this facility. Panchea's security system has been programmed to protect it, and will kill you before you even get close.
You designed that system, Darrow. You can tell me how to shut it down.
But I won't. You think what I'm doing is extreme. You simply don't understand. For humanity to survive beyond this century, it must abandon ill-conceived notions about transcendence and embrace change. But for that to happen, the hard lesson must be learned. Blood must be shed.
Bollocks. Just because there's a technology out there that's making people more powerful doesn't mean that it's going to lead to the destruction of everything. None of the others have in the past. I'm sure augmentation will be fine. Yeah. Can't force people to change. They have to do
nothing
it on their own.
Nothing more to say, Mr. Jensen?
I'm about to say it, Hugh.
What you're doing is horrific. It has to stop. You can't force people to change. They have to do it on their own, or they'll end up resenting you for it. And doing it like this? My God, Darrow, it's insane.
It is not insane, Mr. Jensen. Tragic, yes. Unavoidable? No.
Balls.
You, of all people, should be able to understand this. In your former career, were you not sometimes called upon to kill in the line of duty, to carry that grim responsibility in order to save others? You must realize this is no different. Only the scale has changed. Because the threat we face as a species is so extreme.
But he was appointed by an officially recognized group to kill people. He was killing on behalf of the government, essentially. The elected government. Yeah, it tends to dismiss other people and viewpoints. Let's bring him back to those other people.
You want us to see what you see. Fine. Our humanity is threatened because technology is messing with our minds. But how can we recognize this message when we're grieving over the people you forced us to leave behind? Friends and neighbors, people we care about. Is the image of their murders the vision you want us to have?
Perhaps I should have used a scalpel instead of a sledgehammer. But these are desperate times, Mr. Jensen. Surely you can understand that.
Prick.
Why did I expect this to turn out differently? People like you. People who willingly surrender their humanity a piece at a time. You'll never understand. And browbeating won't get me to change my mind. You can talk and talk and talk, but in the end you'll still fail to grasp the fundamental underlying truth.
At what point did I choose to get augmented? I never asked for this. So they're both about leaving behind, but... Hmm.
Nothing more to say, Mr. Jensen?
I don't know if we should keep appealing. Yeah.
People like me? I'm no different than you, Garrow. I'm still a human being, just like all the men and women you're driving insane out there. Step back for just one moment and see it through our eyes. You've convinced yourself you're saving the world, but you're just lashing out in spite.
No, I didn't mean to imply... Mr. Jensen, please.
That sounds promising.
Your body accepts augmentations easily. So easily, it's like a disease eating you up inside, making you crave more. Well, mine rejects them completely. Yet the desire is still there every day. No, Mr. Jensen, I do not envy you. I understand you. I understand the lengths men will go to obtain what God never wanted us to have. It is why we must see this through to the end.
He sounds pissed off now. But yeah, that's why he walks with a limp and a stick and everything, because ironically, the creator of augmentations, his body rejects them all. We could critique him. He's not used to resistance, and he can be destabilized if his arguments prove wrong. I think we've got it, even if we fail this one, so I want to...
Nothing more to say, Mr. Jensen?
Fuck you, I want to tell him off.
You cover it up with all that pretense about saving the world, try to justify it. But deep down inside, you're nothing more than an angry child. Spiteful, full of hate, envious and bitter. How petty is that?
Petty? I was betrayed by my own genetics, ruined by my own flesh. What right do you have to condemn me? To curse me? All I ever wanted was to build something good. Something magnificent. And now, there's so much blood. So much blood.
Sounds defeated.
I will give you what you want, Mr. Jensen. Codes to shut down Panchea's security system. But you'll still be in danger. Much of the system is self-determining and lethal. When you see it, maybe then you'll understand. The technology I created will not be the future any one of us desires. Please, help the world understand that.
So the main systems are a bit weird, are they? We'll keep that in mind. You have been bested. Good day, sir. Now, is your turret still on? Yeah, it is. But now it looks like we can go through that other wall. I'm not sure we could before.
Richard, the lockdown's disengaged. I'm heading back to the hangar to see if those blast doors are open. Have you been able to raise anyone?
I'm picking up several glimmers, but there's too much interference. I think you're... on your own, Jensen.
Careful there, Francis. You almost sound like you regret that.
This isn't even the right door. Although it's got a thing, so that's always good. Maybe it does lead the right way. That's what you get for blindly following the mini-map again. The marker. Or is this just going to take me all the way back? Is this somewhere earlier in this place? No, it's not. Yeah, it's heavy rifle. And it's that, well, one of the doors that was blocked earlier. But this isn't where I need to be. Alright, so yeah. Somewhere down here and then back the way we came. Question mark. Certainly getting the money's worth out of all the assets in this game. Yeah, it's the old back the way we came. Except now there's goons.
You're the monster. It's your fault.
Right, so this corridor's a dead end. Oh, that's my vending machine.
You're the monster. It's your fault.
You gotta get it together, man. Come on, give it.
You're the monster! It's your fault!
Well, just ignore them all, I think. It's probably easier than trying to take out like 8 dudes at once. Nope, you haven't seen me. I mean, you have seen me, but you can't do shit about it, friend. Probably too stupid to use elevators anyway. It's technical stuff. The lights are on. And somebody is indeed home. Bunch of dudes down there. So, I think the goal is... I remember this room. We've got to get down and get across to the other side of it. But there's multiple ways down, I think. We'll try taking these stairs. Yeah, we might have gone too far down now. We're back to the start. So up we go, and we go across the room, which means to go down this staircase. Much better. Yeah, these guys are all weird. We'll give them a wide berth, I think. Yeah, through this door, there's an old robot friend.
Don't!
Hup! Can you guys climb ladders? Or are you too stupid for that as well? Yeah, you're coming to have a look. Is that because you saw me?
They're closing in on me! The shadows! I see them everywhere!
Either way, down you go. I don't think any of the others are going to be rezzing you anytime soon. You're probably not that smart. Crazy buggers. Now, do we take that ladder? Or do we keep on going? I mean, keeping on going leads to the end of the room, and then maybe we could jump up some shit. But ladders definitely keeps me away from the crazies. And the vent's going in roughly the right direction. Loot. That's why we came up here, maybe. Because that guy's just randomly got a rocket launcher. But we can also pop out onto the old yellow thing. Not sure what these things are or why they're dotted around the place, but we won't look a gift horse in the old gob. This whole detour may have been a big waste of time. It's hard to tell. Yeah, it's just put us back at the start. So let's try going forward this time instead of across the ground floor. That just takes us back to the elevator. That's no fun. Right, guess we're going down again.
Eventually.
Well, it's taking me to a flight of steps. Just taking me back up to this floor that I was on. No, this is a different floor. This is the correct floor, I think. Oh no, wait, there's a vent. Right, you sit down. Now, is that guy going to spot him? And if he is, what's he going to do about it? Now is probably a good time to find out for science. Yeah, it doesn't look like he's going anywhere, really. Oh wait, so we came out of that vent, and then we just didn't go through this door, because we're a bloody idiot, apparently. Well, there we go. Progress is being made. And we're back in the areas with no bad guys. God, look at all these lockers.
It's in my head. You're the one.
It's a treat, that is. Ooh, he's got a sort of drill arm thing. That's pretty useful. But yeah, we're actually going to eschew this locker room. Because we don't care. It's the end of the game. Lockers are no longer necessary. This room, though, is a bit more useful. Let's see, there'll be a password, good. Because there's a shopkeep.
You seem relatively normal, Nishvar.
All things considered, yeah. You okay?
Thankfully, I was able to barricade myself in here when things got out of control. So, is it safe to come out now?
Oh, no.
The rest of the station is still under siege. You better stay here until help comes. In the meantime, is it possible to download Praxis software here?
Yes, of course. No damage was done to the computers. See for yourself.
Yes. One last shopping trip. We can't sell anything anymore. Which is a shame. And we don't need anything anyway, so...
I will remain here, where it's safe. If you need help... or get word of help, please come back.
So yeah, we just popped in really to say hello to Gersa, because it's nice to meet someone else who's got their shit together in this place.
This is William Taggart. If anyone out there is listening, I'm begging you, help. We've barricaded ourselves inside the core server room. Many of us are wounded. Please, save us. Please, save us.
Optional update, find and speak with Bill Taggart. Yeah, we've got options in this final area. So let's work our way through and find out what options we shall take. Now let's see. Need to head down to get to people. Seems the quickest way. And now we're a little lower than we need to be, but we are also a good distance away still, so I think I can safely stroll around at this bottom bit, because yeah, they're all upstairs somewhere. Are they able to get down? Will they see me? Do they care if I jump up here? I don't think they do, really. Crazy fuckers. Right, that's them bypassed. Find to speak with Sarif. Curious. Because of course all the bigwigs are down here. We've met Hudara already. But now we've got Taggart and Sarif to find. Lots of weaponry lying about. It's all fun and games. Yep, that certainly looks like danger. Yep, that also looks like danger.
Sneak. I see you, sneaker.
No, you don't. I mean, yeah, you do. I've got to stop lying like that. Now, security thing, I could turn off cameras, but what's that going to do in this place? It's not like I've got guards. Gas grenades? That gives me an idea. How many gas grenades have I got in my inventory? Tons of the buggers. Yeah, let's make liberal use of them throughout this facility, actually. You guys are just going to... I mean, I could just do that, I guess. Got one. Is that all I got? There we go. Just lure them in. Well, three for the price of one. I'll take it.
No! You won't get me, Foster! You won't get me!
Now we can drop down here. That guy's not hostile.
I don't know. Just leave.
It's just a bit of an Egypt, really. But if I jump up here... Oh no, he doesn't see me. Good.
Stop tormenting me, I can hear you!
Those guys will see me though.
Just let me finish! Just let me finish! I got a job to do! I got a job to do!
So how do we deal with these guys? Same again? Yeah, that worked. Any of you boys want to come and join the fun? Come on! Ah, oh, it wore off.
I'm gonna kill you all! I'm gonna kill you all!
Yeah, this is lacking drama now. But it's all fun. And that's most of them taken down. This tactic's been so effective, even with me spooning it up slightly. I'm tempted to go back and get that other gas grenade. Grand. Snagging that gas grenade gave me time to recharge my battery, so if either of these chumps need taken out, this guy doesn't need taken out. But we're going to do it anyway.
Hey! Hey!
Oh.
Hello! Is anyone there?
Yeah.
Huh? Is there?
We'll take you out, I suppose. It's your own good. They're all men. Have no women been affected by this? I mean, you'd expect it to be mostly men if it's like construction and maintenance workers, but not 100%. This looks like a boss fight, but I'm pretty sure it's not. It's just an elevator of sorts. Accept or cancel. Oh! Whoops. I guess we failed. I guess they were optional side tasks. And we missed them. My bad. Well, that's going to lock off two of the potential endings, but I can broadly explain them, I think. Have we just wandered straight to the final boss fight? I did say it looked like a boss room. I should have probably been more cautious when it said accept or cancel. I probably should have realised something was up. So yeah, I've cut off a little chunk where we just find and rescue Bill Taggart and David Sarraf. Because the game has four potential endings. We've got one of them unlocked by besting Hugh Darrow in that conversation fight. We could have unlocked two and three by finding and saving those two guys. And then there's option four. We should probably stroll down this ominously long corridor. It's like a horizontal elevator. Dead people everywhere, dropping plasma rifles and all sorts of shit.
What the hell? Zhao, what are you doing?
Connecting to Panchaea's Haran project, Mr. Jensen. The most advanced quantum computer slave to the human brain, and the closest to perfection we'll ever achieve. I'm going to use it to hack Darrow's signal and rework the message to our benefit.
Our benefit? You mean the Illuminati's?
Well, yeah, that's the she is a member.
Someone has to override the signal and be the world's savior. And let's be honest, neither of us would trust anyone else to fill that role. Computer, begin EEG sync.
So much pain.
sinking beta waves at 40 cycles per second. Sleep, please. Let me sleep. Incompatible master slave chain detected. Alert. Unable to transfer control to Alpha 5.
The system won't recognize my chip.
Neural systems offline. Rerouting control of the gene.
I can't control Iron.
Increasing glutamate levels by 32%.
Help! Get them out of there! I have to reach the control chamber!
No! I can feel control! I'm in control!
Stop the signal! Security alert! Through the primary control panel!
Oh, shit!
And just like that, we've blundered into the final
Alpha
boss fight.
Pod security inputs. To access Alpha Pod, purge tertiary pods.
Right, so shit's going down. There's women.
I must be the one to alter the signal.
Down there. Twice up the turret.
The council will welcome me with open arms.
But yeah, I think there's a total of 3 women down there. And we need to stop them.
Kill him. You have to have him better,
so
sir.
Yeah, let's rock and roll.
Head down, Johnson.
So we've got that big turret going around the top. Oh, we've got multiples of it.
I'll do it, Mother. Just don't hurt anymore. Just no more pain.
Are there
please,
bad guys
us.
Around? I'm not sure.
Security measures are sufficient.
Oh, yeah.
Sufficient.
Warning.
Ah, fuck. Yeah, I think we have to open those things, then knock out or kill the women. So let's do it with less fuckery
Alpha
this time.
Pod security in place. To access Alpha Pod, purge tertiary pods.
No cameras in here, is there?
I must be the one to alter the
gas
signal. Once I do, the council will welcome me with open arms.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure there's no reason whatsoever for me to do this. Oh, there is a camera. Oh, it's gone now. And doors are opened. Good. That was worthwhile. Right, has that opened up the pod?
You have to have better serve keeping your head down, Johnson.
Error. System.
Yep, we got it.
Rerouting. Connection.
Right. Yeah, we're just putting them out of their misery, really, because they don't look happy.
Complete.
But now she's going to bring out extra threats.
My gaze touches you. There is no escape.
So we've got a bunch of wandering goons now as well. And there we go. Goons down. Really not worried about them too much. Ah, we need to come on around.
Honor and ambition.
Oops, press it, good.
To a whole mile deep in the ocean, about to meet your end.
System failing. Part 2. Safety purge complete.
Look at what they've done.
Right, so that's pod 2 down.
I don't like it here.
I think.
I don't like
it. Or is it? Is it not actually down?
So cool down here. Show us the light.
Can the turrets even hit us for a bit here?
No. I must fight this.
Right, sweet.
I must succeed.
Okay, they can't actually hit us with those turrets. If we just stand here. That kind of makes everything a bit silly, really.
Eliminate you! You have
ruined
everything!
Please!
Stop!
Just die already. There we go. Oh god, someone's shooting me. Ah, someone got me! Was that the turrets? Did they suddenly decide to start hitting me after ages of not hitting me? Maybe I should be more
Alpha
wary
pod
these
security
times.
In place. To access Alpha Pod, purge tertiary pods.
Can I take out the turrets? I've never considered that before.
I'm going to alter the signal. Once I do, the council will welcome me with open arms.
I've got 18 fucking paper turrets.
No! Protect me, brother! Stay away!
That's
stay
nice.
Batman is here. Why does he want to kill us? Kill him.
Yeah, yeah, I think I've blown
you
up one of those turrets.
You have not served keeping your head down.
Now, why didn't I think of this earlier?
Father, mother, just don't hurt anymore. Just no more pain. Please, keep him away from us.
No more pain. We'll sort
security
you out.
Security measures are sufficient. Insufficient.
Diagnostic ward error in systems.
All right, weakening.
Rerouting connection.
Yeah, you dead.
Regaining control.
Oh, turrets are coming back on.
Reroute complete.
I see. Oh no, maybe they're not coming back on. Maybe it's just glowing.
Do you see where honor and ambition lead you? To a whole mile deep in fortune.
Error in system.
Yep, another one down.
Connection.
There's
reroute
goons
complete.
Lurking around, but that's fine.
Look at what they've done.
What's this?
I don't like it here.
Oh, I've done it again.
Like it.
Throwing a gas grenade at myself. What a dick.
Show us the light, mother. Where's the light?
Life support system. Excellent.
Manual override of tertiary pods initiated.
Oh, right. So I probably didn't need to kill them.
Shutting down tertiary stations.
Is this what I'm doing now?
Charges are critical and rising. Electric discharge sequence initialized.
Or am I just going up here?
Get that gold from that fool, Daryl. This will not stop me, Jensen. It's happening. Hurry, he's gone from us.
What am I supposed
no.
to do?
Wait.
Just wait for you to do your thing.
Initiating emergency protocols.
Yeah. Emergency protocols sound fun.
You don't know the resources they have at their disposal, Jensen. Despite your special genetics, you have been in over your head the whole time. Initiate dissipation protocol.
Warning. Electrical charge subcritical and rising.
Oh yeah, I am breaking the glass up.
Discharge sequence.
Down you, Daryl. Give you the strength.
Warning. Primary pod
compromised. Oh yeah, yeah, put a crown on it.
Security measures activated.
Well, this is fun. Yay, we won.
No! I can't
Deus Ex is down. Yeah, I was confused. I thought that boss fight occurred before we came to Panchaea, so I was expecting another couple of sessions of play before we got to the end. But here we go. The Room
Hello,
of Endings.
Adam. Welcome to the Edge. It is not the end of the world, but you can see it from here.
Eliza? What are you doing here?
It is my job to monitor and report on the news, Adam. Before Darrow smothered everything with his signal, the whole world was tuned into this place, including me.
The broadcast. I have to stop it.
I know. Please, come closer. Do you know where we are, Adam? We are at the fulcrum point, when society lies in the balance. Hugh Darrow hoped to tip the scales one way, by telling the world everything you already know. About the biochip, the Illuminati, everything. He believed knowing the truth would convince mankind to abandon research into human enhancement technologies forever.
It would certainly give them reason to fear it.
Indeed. Daryl's confession is ready to send. If you want, I can wideband it across all media as soon as you shut down the signal. Everything you worked so hard to uncover will be exposed. But only if you deactivate the broadcast using this control. Of course, there is another option. This passage leads to Panchaea's pressure regulation controls. Destroy them and the installation will cave in on itself, overwhelmed by the weight of the ocean pressing against it. Everyone inside the structure will die.
That's a solution?
No one will be left to tell the world what happened, Adam. Nobody will be able to spin the story.
Including me.
The choice is yours. Do you believe you have the wisdom to choose an appropriate future for mankind? Or do you trust mankind to find the answers on its own?
So yeah, Eliza has given us two options of the four. If we'd saved Sarah and Taggart, we'd have the other two. So we've got Hugh Darrow's confession, which we can trigger the broadcasts, and that will warn the world that augmentations are dangerous and not to be trusted. Basically. Although we could also go with Sarif's, which was more along the lines of, yeah, it wasn't the augmentation's fault, it was evil people. And we'd spin it that way so that everyone would be totally pro-augment and it'd be super cool. And then the Illuminati one is anti-augment, really. It's the most anti-augment of the three. It's like, yep, the augments were crazy, they fucked us all up. Let's go back to the old wet days where the Illuminati could just control everyone without worrying about it. Because Bill Taggart's Illuminati, so that's his ending. But then the final ending is head down this corridor, blow the base up, everyone in it dies. It was more or less considered the canon ending when they made Mankind Divided, the sequels to this game. Although they've arranged it so that you blew up Panchaea, but everyone got evacuated first. But this is the ending I chose when I played the game first. It's also the ending I think the developers preferred. So yeah, it's time to put the close on this story and let humanity work out the answers for themselves.
If you do this, the world will be left with questions and may never reach a consensus. Are you sure this is your choice?
Well, that sounds nothing like the world I know and love. Yeah, let's do it.
We have little time left, Adam. And might I say, it has been a pleasure.
Do I trust mankind to save itself? That's what Eliza was asking. The truth is, I don't know. After everything I've seen, all the fighting and the chaos around me, I only know what I want to believe. Somehow, human decency will triumph. These past few months, I've faced many life-threatening situations. I could have given up many times, but my need to know the truth, to uncover the secrets that others were hiding, and to survive, forced me to keep on going. Most of the time, I tried to keep my values in mind, knowing my actions did not have to harm others. I held on to my humanity, resisting the urge to abuse power or resources in order to meet my goals. And in the end, I got the job done. But does this mean I have the right to choose for everyone? No. Because it isn't up to me. It isn't up to Darrow, Sarah, or Taggart either. Ordinary men and women will have to decide together what course mankind should take. The kind of people who time and time again have picked and chosen the future in highly practical ways, slowing change when it's negative, speeding it up when it's good. Can they do it again? I don't know. But I do know I'm not about to let anyone in this station, myself included, stand in their way.
And there we have it, ladies and gents. That is one of the endings of Deus Ex, Human Revolution, Director's Cut. If you want to see the other three, check out the game for yourself. It's like probably a fiver by now. It's an old game now. It's a fun game. I think this is probably the last time I'll play through it because I've done everything I need to do multiple times over. But I'm looking forward to playing the sequel at some point in the future, and you can bet that'll be on the channel as well. Other than that though, something different next. And if I can just thank you for watching, then I'll do so. You can't stop me. It's my channel. And yeah, if you want to tickle that subscribe button, leave a little thumbs up on the video, all that shit, then yeah, please do. It helps out when we're a teeny tiny channel and you're like 20% of our viewers all by yourself, possibly. Who knows? Oh yeah. But anyway, thanks very much for watching once again. I'll be back soon with a new series. And now we skip to the post-credit sequence. Ta-ra! Oh, apparently skipping the credits means you don't get the post-credit sequence after all. So we don't get a bit of mystery with Bob Page of the Illuminati. Never mind. Ta-ra!
You worry too much, Morgan. There's nothing we can't manage given time. She's here. I have to cut this short. Keep going through the wreckage. Maybe we'll find something we can use for the Morpheus Initiative. Come in! Dr. Reed! We're so pleased you decided to join us.
Where else could I go?
No regrets, my dear. As Ariadne told Theseus before he entered the Minotaur's Labyrinth, always forward, never left or right. You'll be very interested in our current project. We're breaking new ground.
Yes, the nanite virus chimera is quite intriguing. I'm looking forward to seeing the hybrid project up close, Mr. Page.
And so you shall. But please, call me Bob.